Okay, take a look. I'm going to put this online in case you want to look at it again and rework, whatever. Here we go. Slope is y minus y. So negative 3 minus 4 and negative 7 minus a negative 3. That gives me a negative 7. You have more negatives here, so that's going to be a negative 4. A negative divided by a negative is a positive. Rise over run. Leave it as a fraction, even though it's an improper fraction. It's called rate of change. Slope. Any questions on that? Next. The next one is midpoint. So you add up the x's, which gives you a negative 10. And then you add up your y's, which give you a positive 1. Bless you. This right here turns into negative 5 and 1 half, or 0.5. Any questions on midpoint? A negative divided by a positive is a negative. And finally, distance, put your x's in here. Well, you might have been taught to go backwards, but it doesn't matter. I'm going to go this way. So I'm going to say negative 7 minus, I'm sorry, negative 3 minus a negative 7. Negative 3 minus a negative 7. And then 4 minus a negative 3. It still should work, so just hang in there. This becomes a plus. This becomes a positive 4. If you did it the other way, have a seat, please. I'll get you some. If you did it the other way, it would be a negative. But that's okay when you square it. This right here becomes 7 squared. Here you go. Take 2. All right, so we're going to get 4 squared is 16. And 49, whatever that's going to be, 65, I think. Any questions on how to do distance? All right, you had this on your test yesterday. All right, put away your 5-minute check, please. On a new sheet of paper, put algebra review. And try and work number 7. If you can't do it, just try, okay? Now, I don't think it's a problem in this class, but if you have your book bag or anything on your lap, I'm not going to warn you anymore, okay? Nothing should be on your lap. Today, in one class, I had to give a couple of detentions. I moved them. They were still playing. I had no choice, okay? And that means they got to come after school. I already emailed their parents, etc. So if you don't want to be in that situation, make sure you're doing what I'm asking you to do. Yes, sir. All right, try and work this problem. However you were taught, try and work it. Can't do it, okay, no problem. I'm going to show you how. If you can do it, great. It's just going to make your life easier today. All right, look up here. This is the way I teach it. Now, I don't care if you do it this way or not, but I tell the kids to draw a line to separate this side and that side, and then I tell them to circle the variable. You have to get rid of two things here. You have to get rid of the 6 first and the number with the variable last. That's why it's called a two-step equation. Well, the opposite of a plus 6 is a minus 6. Now, some kids say, well, Mr. Toops, you said minus, and you ended up adding these. Well, that's true, but if the signs are the same, you do have to add. There's no choice. You have to add them if the signs are the same. Now here, the opposite of dividing by 4. If I ask kids to read it, they say K over. We don't want to say over, we want to say divided. The opposite of dividing is multiplying. Some kids have trouble with their signs, so a negative times a positive is a negative. Do your signs first. And then 8 times 4 is 32. Any questions on how to solve a two-step equation? All right. If you're good with that one, let's try one more. Try number 14, please. All right, Mr. Nathaniel, do you have an idea, sir? Subtract 14. All right, so draw your line. Subtract 14, because there's a plus in front. So he's right, you do have to subtract 14. Now you get M divided by 10 equals 10, it looks like. Any questions so far? What do I do now, Miss Caitlin? Why? It's the opposite of dividing by 10. So you're dividing, so you want to multiply. Very good. I get 100. So if you got 100, you're okay. If you didn't, find out what you did wrong. Any questions on how to work that problem? Now look here, if you sell for a living, and you might know somebody who is a salesman or saleswoman, whatever. If you're in real estate, you're selling houses. If you're in real estate and you don't sell any houses, you don't make any money. So you don't stay in real estate very long unless you're married to somebody who's supporting you. And that's good too. But look at this job right here. I want you to read number 15 and try to set up a two-step equation, and then I'm going to show you how to do it. But I want you to try number 15 first. Try number 15 first. Now, while you're reading it, you guys, I mean, we all live by the water, near the water, and that's cool. That's great. That's why I like being here. And if you go out by the water, you see people out on these little sailboats. They live on those sailboats. They don't pay any rent. And that's good if you like living on a sailboat. If they're retired and they got money coming in every month, might work for them. All right, try to set up some kind of equation for number 15. Ten more seconds just to try to set it up. All right, here we go. Read this one here for me, please. Anybody would like to read before I call on somebody? Go ahead, please. Right here. Right here. I'm just messing with you. Go ahead.
Chicken today's salary $500 per month and sales. In addition to the salary, he earns $90 per product that he sells. If his goal is to earn $5,000 per month, how many products does he need to sell?
Very good. Well, look here. He earns $500 a month. Why? Why is that important to Chip? He's guaranteed that money. Even if he doesn't sell anything, he's guaranteed to make 500 bucks. What happens if he continues not to sell anything month after month?
He'll make that 500.
You think they're going to keep him around? They're going to call him into the office and say, hey, man, I like you as a person, but I got to eat too. So you got to sell. And then if he still doesn't sell, it's hard, but that's business. So look here. Plus, he makes $90 for every item that he sells. We don't know. We don't know how many he's going to sell. If he sells five, then you multiply by five. Okay, you got to hustle. If you're a salesperson, when you walk into like some of these furniture places, what's the first thing that happens to you when you walk in one? Boom, you get hit by a salesman. Okay, I say I'm just looking, and then they leave me alone. All right, but you got to understand they're trying to make money. So circle the X. Some people are good at sales, they make a lot of money. Is everybody clear so far? What am I going to do here, Miss Jenna?
You're going to subtract 500.
I'm going to subtract 500. Then what?
Then divide.
Subtract 500. We're going to get some number. Then what?
Divide it by
90. Is everybody clear on what she said? Because she's right. Any questions on that? All right, if you're finishing your test because you get extra time, make sure you look at the video. All right, let's move on. Next, copy down number 13, please. Copy down number 13. And then copy down that chart right there. This is the chart. Now remember, my goal is not to get you to like math. Nobody can do that. I'm just trying to get you to do what you got to do, learn, and move on. Can you wait? I mean, if you can't wait, I'm not going to keep you. But, you know, because I got the video as backup. But I'd like you to stay if you can stay. But if it's an emergency, I'm out the door. I'll deal with the teacher later. All right, you got that chart down? Copy down that chart. All right, look up here. This is called a trinomial. A trinomial can be factored. So put a double bubble. Double bubble is what one teacher calls it. You know that y times y is y squared. Everybody with me so far? Yes? All right. Now, here's the problem. We got to figure something out here. You see how you got two pluses in the problem? You look at the chart. The chart, two pluses, is going to yield two pluses and add. Now, let me show you how you use that. You put your two pluses in here, and here's the question. What times what equals six? That's going to add to give me the five. That's why the chart is going to be good. Now, some kids say six, one times six. Let me show you why this is wrong. What is y times 6? 6y. How much is 1 times y? 1y. What does that add up to? If I change that to a 7, then we'll use that. But it's not. It's a 5, so it should be 2 and what? 2 and 3. Copy that down. That's called factoring. Now, if you didn't learn it last year, learn it now. Let's try one more. I'm going to let you try this one. Try number 17. Copy it down and then try it. I'm going to tell you a little joke, too. I'm not good at jokes, but I'm going to tell you one. This lady is driving down the road, and she sees this new store. She's all excited because she likes the shop. She pulls up, and there's this bird in the window. Big bird. She walks through the door, and the big bird looks at her and lets out a big scream. Ah! And the lady's all embarrassed. All the customers stop and look at the lady. And the bird says, "You sure are ugly." So the lady's like besides herself. She leaves all embarrassed. She goes home. She calls her husband and says, "This is what happened to me." And the husband says, "The bird probably does that to everybody. You want to go there tomorrow." So the lady goes there the next day. She opens the door. The bird screams again and says, "You sure are ugly." So she leaves. She's in tears. She goes home. She doesn't know what to do. She calls her husband. Her husband says, "Call the person who owns the shop and tell them what's going on." So she did that. And the shop owner grabs the bird, puts the bird in the back closet, and talks to the bird. Says, "If you keep embarrassing my customers, I'm not going to be able to afford to feed you. And I'm going to leave you in the back closet. Do you understand?" And the bird shakes his head. So the lady wheels the bird back out to the window because there's an understanding here. The lady comes back. She couldn't believe the bird is still in the window because the shop owner assured her it wasn't going to happen again. So she musters up enough courage. She walks through the door, and the bird looks at her, and she looks at the bird, and the bird goes, "What?" And the bird goes, "You know." Bad joke. Bad joke. All right. You didn't get it. All right. I'll have to edit that since it didn't work. All right. Look up here. R times R is R squared. Look at the chart. I lost my chart. There it is. Look up here now. A negative and a positive is the second one. And the second one says you're going to have two negatives and you're going to add. So put two negatives in there. That chart helps me. So the question becomes, what times what is 27 that's going to add to give me 12? That's the question. Does anybody know? What times what? Go ahead. Yeah, and I usually put the little one first. Now, your teacher from last year should have told you to check the outer and the inner. Look up here. The word FOIL, the outer and inner, gives you the middle term. How much is R times negative 9? Negative 9R. How much is negative 3 times R? And if I add that up, do I get my middle term? So everybody clear on how to factor? Last thing is FOIL itself. See if you can work number 29. Use FOIL and work number 29. And while you're working that, I'm going to pass out these ditto sheets in a moment. I want you to try first.
Draw your arrows. Distribute. All right, I want to call on somebody different now.
Look up here. Jenna, how much is B times B? All right, look up here. Watch. What's one girlfriend plus another girlfriend? Trouble. All right, let me try again. B plus B is to be or not to be. But B times B is B squared. Make sure you know that. So watch again. What is B times B, Miss Jenna? B squared. What's B times negative 2, Miss Jenna? Or not? And what is 2 times B, Miss Jenna? A plus 2B. And finally, a positive 2 times a negative 2. Negative what? 2 times 2 is 4. Is everybody with me so far? Mm-hmm. All right. We're doing three words here. Who knows what the three words are? Yes, ma'am. Combine like terms. Cancel that out. Any questions on how to do FOIL? All right, I'm giving you your paper. Your homework is going to be the paper plus worksheet number 1, but you'll finish this today if you pay attention. Don't waste time. You can write on your sheet. Do not waste time.
Green, white, red. White, yeah. Your white's in the middle.
Maybe like a green. What's the that feels like, too. Ask one of the Caleb.
Major.
Yeah, it's a new schedule. Feels like 3. Could be wrong.
You need help smile.
It says, watch the video if you need help.
Okay. And
you know.
Sorry. Yes, put your name at the top. The student one period said, what does this stand for?
Name, date, period.
And I said, put down Einstein. I was being silly.
Not your date for the weekend, Miss Cadell. You know.
Did you just do it for me? Let me just see this question.
Hmm? I think, were you going to the bathroom?
No, not yet.
If you need help, you need to raise your hand.
I don't get the number.
No, stay there, sir.
I have 7.
Stay there, sir. Sit down, please. Ask your question. You don't understand the format.
The numbers are just like guides. The seven.
What?
Each line is a new number.
Somebody here at 6 o'clock in the morning did not want to put the numbers here. So here's 7, here's 8, 9, 10. You with me?
Yeah.
Just fill it in. Who else needs help? His question is, what are we doing on this page? And my answer is, put your hand on this page and move it around. What does that mean? You're doing all of it. Now, you don't have to do the back. Got you looking. Not your day for this weekend. Who needs help?
Wait, what was the answer for number 14? We did it.
Oh, what was the generator?
If you need help, you need to raise your hand.